a woman's primary agency is her sexuality. That means, even if a woman has a PhD, she's a CEO. When men are picking women, they pick them based on the education they have. They look at their beauty and their youth. Okay.
The beauty and the youth. That is very interesting that you're talking about the youth.
Yes.
Why are you talking about the youth?
Because the youth has an impact on whether she's reproductive.
Reproductive, or is beautiful.
Yes, it's both. It's tied, but also you can find a woman who is beautiful even in her 40s.
Yeah.
But she may not be able to have a child.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's why the youth comes in. If you look at, and this is something that is hardwired in men. If you interview men who are 18 years, if you interview men who are 32 years, men who are in their 40s, men who are in their 70s, men want the same thing from women.
Mm.
They want a young, beautiful woman. If you interview an 18-year-old woman and a 40-year-old woman, they don't want the same man.
Mm.
Yes. And that's why also men have struggled to understand women, because women don't remain the same. Women keep changing based on their ovulatory cycle and based on their age. A woman who is in her 20s, she's wild. She wants that alpha guy, by the way. She's willing to take the risk and get pregnant with him, even though there is that risk of offspring abandonment. A woman in her 30s doesn't want a bad boy anymore. She now wants someone who she can settle with, someone who has an 8-to-5
the
job.
The guy was a sense of bread and butter.
Yes, him. Yes. The guy who she can tell, I want you home by 8, and the guy will be there by 8. You see?
Mm.
But when she's in her 20s, she doesn't mind running around with the bad boys.